Copy that on wind loads. Sim team Frank on countdown one.
LD verify, go for launch.
Loads look good.
Loads look good, box is closed out. Box load station 2 closed out in 2 minutes.
LC, LD, go for launch.
Copy.
T-minus 1 minute. BC, verify F9 is in startup.
Falcon 9 is in startup. Flight software has control of the vehicle. Stage 1, stage 2, pressing for flight.
T minus 30 seconds. T minus 20 seconds.
Falcon 9 is configured at flight pressures.
T minus 15. T minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have liftoff of Falcon 9. Falcon 9 is clear of the tower.
Michael Hammersley, materials engineer, and I'm going to talk you through some of what you're seeing and hearing as the vehicle continues to ascend. You can tell that we've had a successful liftoff initially. The Falcon 9 has cleared the towers, and it is rapidly approaching what's called maximum aerodynamic pressure. This is known as Max-Q. It's when the rocket is pushing
seconds.
Hardest against the
speed
atmosphere.
Speed 550
you can
meters
hear
per second, downrange
dead
distance 2.3 kilometers.
You can see the engine
plume. Stage one propulsion is nominal.
The engine plume widening as the rocket is increasing in altitude and there's less pressure.
Launch air power still look healthy.
Come on, Fury!
MVAC has begun chill.
MVAC chill means that the second stage engine is preparing itself to ignite. Shortly after main engine cutoff, we're going to separate the stages and begin the second stage ignition.
T plus 2 minutes, speed 1.2 kilometers per second, downrange distance 11 kilometers.
Main engine cutoff approaching shortly. The fairings have successfully deployed. You can hear everyone is phenomenally excited here. The Merlin vacuum engine is burning bright as it's moving up to speeds approaching 8 kilometers per second. The first stage will soon begin its series of three burns to head back towards Cape Canaveral. First, it will reorient itself. It will reorient itself using cold gas thrusters. It will perform three more burns as it approaches landing zone one.
Stage one boost back is starting.
The boost back is the primary burn that will get the vehicle moving more slowly.
Stage two propulsion is nominal.
And heading back to Cape Canaveral.
Track position of signal.
Man, that is awesome. We are well on our way to taking Orbcomm's orbit, and that boost back burn, that's the first step of a really intense process to get that stage one back on land, man.
Yeah, like so many things just happened. my heart beat twice. two beats since we were on last, first of all. Secondly, there were so many important things. There was first the takeoff, the immediate takeoff, which is just a huge relief. Then there's max Q, and you have the maximum pressure. Past that, huge relief. Then the stage separation, and everyone here went nuts. People here are going crazy. And then the boost back. So everything is so far looking great, right?
So far, so good. Yeah, that boost back burn is going to go on for 30 seconds, and then it's going to cut off. We're going to flip the stage back around, and as we enter that atmosphere, those grid fins are going to pop out and start the guidance in through the atmosphere.
And so we're about 4 minutes away from when it would touch down, right?
Exactly. Okay.
Yes, about 4 minutes away.
Everyone's really excited.
A lot of energy.
Awesome.
A lot of
energy. So much energy. Yeah, that boost back burn is really important because it reorients us back down to the launch site, back down to landing zone one, as opposed to normally after the first stage separates from a rocket, that first stage will continue on a sort of ballistic trajectory and crash into the ocean, but we are coming back to land.
One of the things I think that is another thing that I just not that intuitive is what an orbit is. And so right now, the second stage is going far to orbit.
Right.
Yeah, it is going faster and faster and higher to try to ping these satellites off into orbit. And what that means is you're not floating in orbit. The gravity is almost the same as it is on Earth. So what's happening is it's almost like the second stage is like a giant throwing the satellites as hard as you can so that they're going 17,000 miles an hour. So you can basically curve around the Earth. They're falling, but they're going so fast that they're actually curving at the same curvature of the Earth.
And I know the same thing. A lot of people that I think of space as just going up really high and back down, which is a lot of like space tourism kind of things. But what we're trying to do is we're trying to deliver satellites and stuff like that.
They're super fast,
really fast
sideways.
Which is why it's really hard to bring this stage back, because the faster you go, the harder it gets to actually come back as well.
Yes. So, and also, you know, being able to get all of these satellites into that orbit, that's really hard. But then having 11 and getting them to maintain their orbit is also really difficult.
But let's check in actually with John Innsbrucker for another update on how both the second stage burn is going and also how that first stage is looking too.
We're at T+7:30. Everything continues to go nominal, as we like to say here at SpaceX. Falcon 9 continues to power its way into orbit. The second stage is building up to 4.7 Gs of acceleration. Now, currently, we're about 2 minutes away from shutdown of the second stage engine to get into orbit. Engine performance continues to be nominal. I'm looking at the trajectory. We're going right down the middle of the track. That's good news. We're right where we want to be. For the first stage, you heard about the first boost back burn. Coming up in another minute or so, or coming up very shortly, is the entry burn, and then hopefully the landing burn. And you hear the cheering in the background.
First stage is on its way. Everyone's super excited out here. That burn's gonna last about ourselves down as we get closer and closer to the landing pad.
Yes. Now this stuff is super, super hard. Not only do we have a series of maneuvers that we need to achieve in order to get that rocket back down to the ground, but it's actually a super complicated thing. Like, you did some cool analogies, cool math to figure this out.
I tried to figure out how hard this really is, and so I crunched the numbers with the size of the rocket and the size and how high it's going. Yeah. What's happening with the first stage is it's like launching a pencil over the Empire State Building, having it reverse, come back down, and land on a shoebox on the ground in a windstorm. That's what's happening.
The critical part.
Yes. And I don't think I could throw a pencil over the Empire State
it's
Building
insane
and catch
thing
it on
to try to do.
And the crazy thing is we're like 30 seconds away from this.
From this
awesome.
Crazy maneuver.
This extremely energetic room is a hush. Should be deploying in about 10 seconds or so. That is a view from the landing pad.
That is that first stage coming back down to land and kicking up. History in the making, guys.
Stage one is landing. LZ-1, the Falcon has landed. Landing operators moving to procedure 11.100, section 3 on LZ-1, VNet, recovery net.
Repeat, the Falcon has
landed. 611 kilometers.